Chapter 1 is called the web of life, and that's always been my definition of ecology, that it is the scientific study of how everything hangs together. Every week, you will have to read about one chapter in our textbook. So yes, you really need to buy or rent the book. And every week I'll post a lesson like this one on Insight that gives you some additional background, maybe a video, and some practice questions. I chose the book because it has a pretty good companion website where you can find web extensions, study tools, and more. In addition, it has hands-on problem-solving exercises that I will assign from time to time. And I especially like that every chapter has a case study that applies the Dreyer concepts to real-life issues. The case study for that first chapter is about frogs. Did you know that the northern Pacific tree frog that you can see here is the most common frog in San Francisco? You can recognize it by the wide dark stripe through the middle of each eye that extends from the nostrils to the shoulder. It's pretty small, just a little bit bigger than a quarter. But males have a bigger than a quarter. But males have a really big voice. My name means frog in my native German dialect, and I was always fascinated by these creatures. For once, just think of their life cycle. Starting out as an egg mass, pretty unprotected, then spending some time as a tadpole in water with gills and a tail, and then metamorphizing to becoming a frog living on land and breathing through the lungs. And there's also the North American wood frog that can survive with 65% of the water in its body frozen.
There is no breathing, no kidney function. The heart stops.
And there'll be no heartbeat for a long period of time. What,
you mean as in no heartbeat?
Right.
Nothing.
Flatline.
Flatline. For an hour or two?
It could be for days, perhaps even weeks.
Really? It sounds like it's virtually dead, no?
We know that the frog isn't dead, but he's probably about as close as you can get
to being dead.
Yes.
So, from the outside, this little frog feels like a rock. Except that as it froze, the frog flooded itself with a kind of sugar.
The frog's blood sugar is distributed through the circulatory system. It works like an antifreeze.
It's harder for the water to freeze, so cells stay just damp enough for the animal to hold itself together. Until the springtime. When the days grow a little longer, and the ground gets a little warmer, and then, well, a kind of miracle happens. After weeks or months of no heartbeat, none, suddenly, there's a pulse. And that first heartbeat leads to another, and then another. And then within a day, and in the case of this little frog, it took about 10 hours, the animal literally comes back to life.
This frog is intensely studied to learn how we can freeze organs for transplant without damaging them. The case study you're about to read is pretty alarming, not as cute as this little song.
Together.